Coogan Cassius Rifle TV in association with MTK Global. We're at the public workouts here for Hay Bellew. Davies Matthews with me. I've got Derry Matthews. Keeping an eye on your opponent there.
Let him do what he wants to do, Coogan. I'm done. I'm ready. We'll have a sweatsuit on in a minute. Get his weight off.
Obviously, we spoke after the press conference the other day, Derry. After, we saw David Hay send some tweets out saying that he'd sort of got a bit of racial abuse from the Liverpool crowd at the press conference. I didn't hear anything, but I don't know what you made of that, really.
I didn't. To be honest, I haven't checked his social media. I don't follow him. And it's bullshit. He's just wanting people to feel sorry for him. In my eyes, listen, he's just looking for an excuse. He's looking for people to blame. He got absolutely annihilated. Not by just by the crowd, by Tony as well. And I've never seen David Hay fume like that at all at a press conference.
Yeah, I mean, we saw, you know, David, of his own admission, to some degree, say, you know, he kind of lost it with, you know, we saw clips afterwards where he was talking about people's mums and everything, but he was getting it, David. So I suppose there is the argument there that why can't he give a little bit back?
I understand that because I'm the worst. Like, people give me it on Twitter and I give them it back. Do you want me to block them? I don't block them. I just give them it back. That's what social media is for. To have a laugh, like, not a laugh, but to give banter back. And to be honest, I've met a lot of good people through giving stick back and people giving it to me. So, but with David saying all the racist stuff, I'm not having it. I'm not buying into that at all.
But I mean, listen, it was a lively press conference, probably one of the most lively ones, you know, there has been in a long time. But that's kind of done. You lot have got it should be a more civil one tomorrow. Yeah. There's no public there. But yeah. In that situation again.
But in his own city now, and let's see what he's got to say. I said what I had to say. I've moved up to 140. I've come to London. What more do you want? He asked for this fight. He's got the fight. There's no pulling out now. He's in deep water. There's no pulling out. I'm here. I'm ready to fight. And I think he's realising now, what have I done? What have I done? But now it's, you know, now it's time to show him that I'm here to take the belt off him.
What does a win over O'Hara Davis do for your career at this stage?
It's a massive. You know, look, you got to realise that 33 years of age, I'm one of them fighters where no one will really want to fight me because I can punch and does anyone, you know, want to take that risk? I think he's got this fight because of his social media mouth. And Eddie's thought, wow, this has gone massive on social media, and it's happening. I don't think he wants to fight, if I'm honest. And now he's got the fight, and beating him on Saturday, you know, as I stated the other day, at 140, Crawford's the WBC world champion now. Crawford's most probably never heard of me or him, if I'm honest. He's never heard of us. So I think, I don't know whether you're automatically mandatory for the WBC belt if you win the silver. I think that's been...
But we've seen it. I mean, we've seen Callum Smith win it, but then it take a while for it to become that, get the final eliminator.
We've seen Swifty win it, I think he become mandatory as well. So, you know, if you do become mandatory, Crawford's not going to fight us, he doesn't know us. So, with a bit of luck, he'll vacate the belt. I'm praying he vacates the belt and I can fight, you know, one of the Brits. If not, you know, there's Ricky Burns out there as well, who's, I think, going to win. Ricky's a great fighter, got a lot of respect for Ricky. I've had some great spars over the years with him. He's one of, you know, he's been down, he's come back, and look what he's done with his career. Multiple world champion, and, you know, I beat O'Hara Davies. He's a stable mate of Ricky Burns, so, you know, Eddie might put that on. Or if Collar gets beat to Linares, Collar might want to move up to 140, and there's a massive fight there. So there's big things, and I think it's a good move by Eddie by putting this fight on, because if I win, or when I win, I should say, there's other options, but at the same time, I'm still a Frank Warren fighter, and I'm sure Frank's got big plans for me.
Okay, well, listen, I'm going to let you get off. We'll see you at the press conference tomorrow.
Thanks.
I hope there's more fun and games.
Five-hour drive to get here. The trains are closed in Liverpool. Nightmare.
Yeah, I hope everything's all right in Liverpool.
I know, that's the only problem. A lot of people will come in the public workout. I think there's more scouts up there in this public workout than there is for him in the ring now. So it just shows you how exciting it's going to be on Saturday. And then the weigh-in's going to be, you know, there's a couple of thousand coming down for the weigh-in.
We look forward to it.
Top man, Coog.
All right, thank you very much,
Derek. Thank you very much, mate.
Cheers, mate.